Welcome back to our weak acid strong base titration. For our examples, we are working with 0.10 molar acetic acid, 25 milliliters of that, and we are adding volumes of 0.10 molar sodium hydroxide. The first point in our titration is when we have added 0 milliliters of sodium hydroxide. And so an equivalent question would be to calculate the pH of 25 milliliters of 0.10 molar acetic acid. And of course, given the Ka value because we have a weak acid. Since we only have weak acid in solution, our pH is calculated just by the pH of that weak acid. Acetic acid dissociating in water, because both of our reactants are weak, this sets up equilibrium to produce our conjugate base of acetate and hydronium ion because we have an acid. We have our 0.10 molar acetic acid solution, and again, because this sets up equilibrium, we would have an ice table here if we wanted to set that up. I, of course, am not requiring that, so that is optional. What I do expect you to still set up is your equilibrium expression. We have our products over our reactants. And since everything reacts in a one-to-one ratio here, we have no exponents to worry about. And if we remember from our ice table for all of our reactions here, this equation always comes out to be x squared over our initial concentration minus x. Setting that equal to our Ka value, we get this mathematical equation to solve. And of course, because we have a small K value, the easiest way to solve it is to assume our bottom x is zero. Our solution for x then is the square root of our Ka value times our initial acid concentration. Our value for x in this example is a 0.001342 molar, and always helpful to remind ourselves what x represents because we have an acid solution that is hydronium. And so our pH calculation will be the negative log of our x value. When we round for sig figs here, of course, our two sig figs in concentration means we have two decimal places in pH. Our beginning pH value for this titration is 2.87.